Hey guys, this is Austin. Take one look at the ASUS ZenBook S13 and you will see that there is a lot going for it. I want to give a real shout out to ASUS for hooking us up with the ZenBook a little bit early. This won't be going on sale until around March or so, so we have a slightly pre-production unit, but beyond that, this thing looks dope. This is a 97% screen to body ratio, which means that you're essentially getting a 14-inch screen and a 13-inch laptop size. Now the way they do this is with very thin bezels on the sides, as well as a little bit of a anti-notch or a reverse notch. You got a little tab maybe. Instead of moving the webcam down below the screen or onto the keyboard, this actually seems to be a pretty decent approach. It gives you a little bit of something to grab when you're opening up the laptop, and it means that you still do have a decent quality webcam. Don't get me wrong, it's not amazing with a 720p resolution,
but this is so much better than if it was like this.
The other key to this is the bottom bezel. It's there, but you just can't see it. So that's thanks to the Ergo Lift hinge. So when you actually open up the laptop, what happens is that it slightly elevates the keyboard, and that has a couple of advantages, including making it a little bit more comfortable to type on, giving you more cooling, and importantly, totally making it look like there's not a bottom bezel of the screen at all. It's a really clever piece of technology and engineering, and it's just smart. It's also helped that this is a solid display. Now it's not a touchscreen, it is only 1080p resolution, but honestly, I prefer that for battery life. And importantly, the panel itself is very high quality. It's very accurate, and it is one of the brightest laptop displays we've ever tested. Bezel-less smartphones have kind of taken over, and laptops are starting to take that trend. But what's cool about this is that it actually makes a big difference, right? I mean, you're getting a legitimately bigger screen and a chassis which is just as small as a lot of the other 13-inch laptops that we've been using the last few years. It's one of those things where there's no real downside, there's no real gimmicks here. It's just some smart ideas and a cool way of making a laptop just that little bit much better. That brings us to the second claim to fame for the ZenBook S. This is the world's thinnest laptop with dedicated graphics. And yeah, that's pretty thin, 13 millimeters. The NVIDIA MX150 inside is hardly the most powerful GPU in the world, but it is a huge step up over integrated graphics. This is enough power to play most games as long as you don't mind turning down the settings a little bit. So for example, here in Fortnite, I've got it at 720p medium, and we're able to get a pretty consistent 50 to 60 frames per second. The only issue is that because this is so much power in such a thin and light laptop, it means that it does run a little bit warm, especially on the keyboard, and the fans, they can spin up a little bit. It's not crazy loud, but it's definitely much louder than most ultrabooks. Open it up and we see that's actually, wow, okay. So first of all, it has a dual fan setup, which does make sense considering we do have not only a CPU, but we also have a GPU. Also, I just realized this says unstoppable. Are they like trying to keep jerry-rig everything out? So it does look like you can swap out the NVMe SSD, but what's really impressive is just how big of a battery they were able to fit. This is a full 50 watt hours, so usually when you add a GPU to a laptop, it means that not only is it pulling more power, so you need that bigger battery, but on top of that, there's less room for an actual battery as far as the physical space. You've got to add room for the cooling, the GPU, but here they've got pretty much a full-size cell, and you've got the power to back it up. So in addition to the MX150, you have a Whiskey Lake 8th generation Core i5 or Core i7. You also have up to 16 gigs of RAM, and all the way up to a 1 terabyte PCIe SSD. Build quality is solid. So not only is the keyboard deck very rigid, but even the screen really doesn't have any flex to it. A big reason for that is because unlike most other laptops out there, this starts life as a single block of aluminum, which is then CNC milled down to get what you see here. Now that's usually reserved for very expensive laptops such as Razer as well as Apple options. So it's nice to see on a ZenBook. And I think it's probably part of the reason why they're able to get so much power into such a small and thin form factor. The fundamentals are all here. The keyboard feels great thanks to the Ergo Lift design. The touchpad is a little bit on the small side, but it works and it does have a fingerprint sensor. And you have a decent selection of ports. No Thunderbolt 3, but you do have two USB-C, a micro SD card reader, as well as a full-size USB-A. I'm really impressed with the ZenBook S. Not only is the bezel-less display nice, but more importantly for me, you're getting a lot of performance here without sacrificing the form factor. I don't have to carry around a heavier laptop to have my GPU as well as have my 14-inch screen. Now the only downside here is that price is not announced yet. So as long as this is reasonably priced, I think that they've definitely got a winner here.